Today it is the Solemnity of Divine Mercy. Our Lord rose from the dead and granted his mercy and peace for all who seek these gifts of faith. Let us cast off our old ways and seek the divine mercy of our Lord. This Mass is offered for Norma Brachita.
Please stand and join in singing our processional hymn, number 577 in the music issue, The Strife is O'er, 577.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, on this second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday, the day that we ask our Lord to open up his fountain of mercy and forgiveness for us and for the whole world, because of his sorrowful passion and his glorious resurrection. You know that our focus is here in the image of the Divine Mercy with the signature, Jesus, I trust in you. To show our trust in him, let us confess our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Son, Lord God, love.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own. But they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them. For those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles. And they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
Let the of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
I was hard pressed and was failing, but the strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. a joyful shout of victory in the tents of the just.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome. For whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
With your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of the first day of the week, when the doors were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when he came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my hand into the nail marks and put my hand into his side, I will not believe. Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, but do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and still believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Divine Mercy Sunday was a gift to us by Pope St. John Paul II, our beloved Pope, who on the day of his own death, people were screaming for him to be canonized a saint. You remember that, some of you? Santo subito, which in Italian means saint fast, subito, right now. Such was his holiness. When he was a young man, there was a nun by the name of Helen Kowalska. In the 1930s, she became Sister Faustina Kowalska, and like most religious, gave up her name Helen. Sister Faustina was given a great grace in her convent in Krakow, not very far from where Pope St. John Paul was born and raised and went to seminary. She received private revelations or visions of the Lord. Anytime that happens, our church immediately becomes suspect, and it should, and it should. It takes a long time before the church would proclaim a private revelation as something that we should all believe. A long time. Lourdes, a long time. Fatima took a long time before it entered our liturgy and our prayers, and such was the case with Faustina. However, when she was alive and having these revelations, out to the seminarians went her diary, her writings on what the Lord was revealing. And so this young seminarian named Carol Wojtyła fell in love with the Lord of Divine Mercy. And guess what happened? Well, first, the church did what it usually does. It suppressed Sister Faustina's writings. Suppressed them. You shouldn't read them, and you shouldn't pray with them. Sounds like Padre Pio, and I can name you 25 other saints. Any of you see the movie about Cabrini? Yeah, I hope you did. A lot of you saw the movie about Cabrini. Well, poor Michael Augustine Carrigan, Archbishop of New York, in his grave is still moaning that he let Mother Cabrini walk right by his door. Actually, he wanted to send her back to Italy. But this goes on. So when Sister Faustina died, her writings were locked up with her in her Krakow convent to be forgotten forever, except guess what happened? What happened in 1979? Carol Wojtyła became Pope John Paul II, and he never forgot. Out came the diary, published first in 30 languages. Out came the chaplet. Out came the novena. Out came the image of the Divine Mercy. That one over there, by the way, is the second of three images that Saint Faustina herself approved. while she was still alive, because in one of her revelations, the Lord said to her, "Find someone who could paint a picture of me as you see me. As you see me, risen from the dead, Easter. With my marks in my hands, but my hand raised to forgive sins, and that blood and water, red and white, pale white, coming from my sacred heart." And so they did a painting, the original. It's on a holy card over there. She said, "Almost." They did the second one. "Almost." Did the third one, which all of you do know. It's probably the most propagated image of the Divine Mercy. We have one out here. We have one in the confessional. And she said, "Almost." It was never going to happen. There was never going to be a painter that was going to paint Jesus the way St. Faustina actually saw him. But we have three images that she, in her own lifetime, approved, even though they were not perfect. And that's the second one of them over there with the flowers at the feet. For some reason, our Lord revealed to St. Faustina that the image of Jesus, the Divine Mercy, with his hand raised, coming toward you, forgiving your sins, with the blood from his cross and the water from his cross flowing out of him, should be venerated. Venerated. You know what veneration means? That prayers should be said before this image, and that a signature should be written. Gesù, io confio in te. Jesus, I trust in you. And that those words should be said and emblazoned until the Lord comes again in glory. But the Lord told St. Faustina, the second Sunday of Easter is the Sunday of my divine mercy. And the church said, never, never. The second Sunday of Easter is what we call Low Sunday, Domenica in Albis, Dominica in white, Sunday in white, to remember that Easter was only 8 days away. It's never going to happen. Guess what? In the year 2000, that little nun that was suppressed became Saint Faustina Kowalska. And in that year, Pope Saint John Paul declared the first Sunday of Easter, the second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday for the whole world. And that the image of the Divine Mercy should be propagated and copied into every church, chapel, or home that would trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. And now, from Siberia to Argentina, you'll find that image like the image of the Sacred Heart. Powerful. What is this Divine Mercy? It's the reminder of why he died on the cross, why he rose from the tomb, why you're sitting in church, ridden with sin as we are. Why? Because of his divine mercy, God's mercy, always ready to forgive, always ready with the second chance, always ready to help us, his divine mercy. Jesus, I trust in you. Now, if you really want to know all the messages of divine mercy, some of you may know, she wrote a 1,000-page diary. Wow. I've been reading it since 1983. I'm not finished yet. And it's in paperback. You could all get it. She spent a lot of time with our Lord, and we are the recipients of that message. So today you come to the Eucharist in Easter, and on Divine Mercy Sunday, I hope that many of you, most of you, all of you, will receive what's called a plenary indulgence. A plenary indulgence is a very special blessing that's given to us through the power of the keys in the church for those who do a few things. Receive Holy Communion. Got it. Venerate the image. In 10 seconds, we're about to do it. Got it. Pray for the Pope at the end of Mass. We're going to do it together. Got it. Make a good confession. between Ash Wednesday and Pentecost Sunday. Well, I hope most of you went between Ash Wednesday and Easter, but if you didn't, Father Dinesh is going to be in the box at 1:30 today. The box meaning the confessional box room. And you have until Pentecost, 50 days almost, to go to confession and to say, Jesus, I trust in you. And then act like the divine, merciful Lord himself by forgiveness in your heart, by praying for peace in the world, by praying for an end to violence, all the things we're already doing. Those are the requirements to receive yourself this plenary indulgence, and they're right here at your feet. So I'm going to go over, and I'm going to consecrate the image, which will be our way of venerating the image. Check. Then we're going to have the Eucharist. Check. We're going to pray for the Holy Father after communion. Check. Confession's up to you. And the living of the life of divine mercy. I wish, Jesus said, to open wider than my arms my immense divine mercy and shower it on the world. Would that my people would pray for that, for their own families and for the world. If we trust Jesus, he would not go back on his word. Every word in Faustina's diary resonates with the scriptures, with the Bible and the teaching of the church. So you have no need to fear trusting this message of divine mercy. So now you join me from your hearts. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. John Paul, go get me the incense and the boat. My brothers and sisters, we have genuine reason to rejoice because we are about to bless this image of our Lord Jesus Christ, the divine mercy, to be erected for public veneration today. This image honors above all the truth that Jesus is the visible image of the invisible God. He who sees me sees the Father, he said. Therefore, when we honor this image, let us lift up our eyes to Christ, who reigns forever and ever. Amen. Three times join me. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Reaffirming our faith in Jesus, the Trinity and the Church, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begot and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With faith and hope, we bring our prayers to the Father through Jesus Christ, our life and our resurrection.
Please respond, Risen Lord, hear our prayer. On this Divine Mercy Sunday, may the church and our parish community be a place where the mercy of God is cherished and shared with others. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis and all church leaders, may they be ministers of forgiveness. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
That our Divine Redeemer protect all of our armed forces, the policemen and women, firefighters, and all those who care for us at great sacrifice. May they be kept safe and healthy. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the Catholic faithful who worship in our parish of Immaculate Conception and Assumption of Our Lady, may the joy of the resurrection fill our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the suffering, may the Lord be close to them in their trials. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember those for whom we offer this Mass, especially Norma Brachita, and those who died this week, especially Jack Gravenese and Vincent Capulia. May the risen Lord take them to paradise. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now add our own intentions in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer. God of glory and majesty, great indeed is your name. Help us to live in the light of the risen Christ and to trust in our Lord's divine mercy, because he is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
As our gifts are presented and prepared, please join in singing number 176. Ye sons and daughters, we'll start with verse number 4, number 176.
Thou art my Lord, and God we cry.
Pray, my brothers and my sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblation of your people and of those you have brought to our faith, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time of Easter above all, to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you to make us holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night that he was betrayed, he himself took bread. He said the blessing, he broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into glory, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect in the company of the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Peter and Saint Paul, Saint Mark and Saint Luke, Saint Mary Magdalene, Saint Faustina, Mother Teresa, Padre Pio, Saint John Paul II, and all the saints on whose constant intercession we rely in your presence for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of the whole world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant, Pope Francis, Timothy Dolan, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family that you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Stretch forth your hand and feel the place where the nails were. Alleluia. And be not doubtful, but believing. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Glory be to the Father and to the Son. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Let us pray.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The third element of this plenary indulgence, the praying to our for our Holy Father, Pope Francis. And so we together pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. We have just two announcements. We are having our usual adult faith formation classes during the Easter season, beginning April 18th. This year, we will have a study of the Gospel of St. Mark, which we will proclaim the whole rest of the year. Dr. Enrique Aguilar will be giving those talks in our lower church. Please see the bulletin for details and how to call to sign up. The Cardinal's annual stewardship appeal is off to a good start. You can see that in the bulletin. We are always assessed a certain goal, and you should have received a letter and a pledge card from me this week. I'm going to ask you, last year we reached our goal, but we reached it with about 220 families. We have 3,000 families in the parish. Could I ask you, if you have never made a pledge or a little gift to the appeal, to do so this year? It will mean a lot. It goes to an awful lot of wonderful services in our diocese for Cardinal Dolan. So I would ask you to think about that. Lastly, what are we about to do? And what about the rest of the afternoon? First, what we're about to do. I'm going to beg your indulgence, out of respect for the Blessed Sacrament, to stay with me just for a few minutes while I expose the Blessed Sacrament and we sing O Salutaris Hostia, which I'll tell you where to find it. When I've exposed the Blessed Sacrament, I'm going to get up. When you see me get out, up, you can quietly leave the church if you wish. You can remain to pray. You can come and make your own veneration of the image. We are privileged in this parish to have what's called a first-class relic of St. Faustina Kowalska. It's been sitting on the altar the entirety of the Mass, right here. It was given to me by our Vicar General in the year 2004. It is a piece of her shoulder bone, St. Faustina. What I'm going to do is, since we've already publicly venerated this image, I'm going to go to the other side of the sanctuary, and anyone that wishes to venerate the image of St. Faustina, not the image, the relic of St. Faustina, could come to me. Some of you could come here. Some of you could kneel and pray before the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament, and most of you will probably go home. You know that for the rest of the afternoon until 3 o'clock, we'll have the rosary. Father Adolfo will come out at 3 o'clock to pray the chaplet, and then benediction to end the afternoon. Father Dinesh from 1:30 forward will be in the confessional back there. And of course, there's time for prayer and meditation. You can go and come back if you wish. Till 3 o'clock, the hour of mercy and benediction. Clear enough? Clear enough? Good. John Paul, could I ask you two to bring the incense to me and everyone else to just kneel? Oh, there it is. Go to behind me. Just pick it up. Pick up the boat and the incense.
Please join in singing O Salutaris Hostia, which may be found in the back cover of the missalette on the top right-hand corner.
Dear Lord, as we have venerated your image, prayed for the Holy Father, received Holy Communion, confessed our sins, I ask you to grant your plenary indulgence upon all those who have or will during this Easter season fulfill these requirements. Grant them freedom from any temporal punishment due to sin. More importantly, as we have thanked you for your divine mercy, we beg you, bring peace. And violence. Bless families, marriages. Keep our children in your sacred heart. And bring us ever closer to you, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Go in peace. Please come out of the, step out of the, back up till Tuesday.
We're going to read book or chapter by chapter.
It's the 1 year anniversary of my sister Lydia,
Audrey James,
and her husband just before Christmas.
Right.
So the two of them were in heaven.
I'll remember them both.
I do. She left on the 12th, which is my birthday day.
Mm-hmm.
She left on my birthday.
Wow, beautiful.
So, I said, well, maybe they're celebrating up there.
Could be.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Thank you so much, Father.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Let us pray the glorious mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The first glorious mystery is the resurrection. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fire of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who need most of your divine mercy. The second glorious mystery is the Ascension. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who need most of your divine mercy. The third glorious mystery is the descent of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles and the Blessed Mother. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who need most of your divine mercy. The fourth glorious mystery is the Assumption. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who need most of your divine mercy. The fifth glorious mystery is the coronation of the Blessed Virgin Mary as Queen of heaven and earth. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, especially those who need most of your divine mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor, banished children of Eve. To you do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping these valley of tears. Turn, the most gracious advocate, your eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, Holy Mary, Mother of God. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life. Grant, we beseech you, that we who meditate on these mysteries of the most of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may meditate what they contain and obtain what they promise. Through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. We will have now another few minutes of silence and right at the moment of the hour of mercy at 3 p.m., we'll start the Chaplet of the Divine Mercy. Thank you. Let us pray on this hour of mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, 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 for the sake of his sorrowful passion. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, 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 for the sake of his sorrowful passion. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, 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 for the sake of his sorrowful passion. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, 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 for the sake of his sorrowful passion. 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 Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion. 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 Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and the whole world. Eternal God, in whom mercy is endless and the treasure of compassion inexhaustible, look kindly upon us and increase your mercy in us, that in difficult moments we might not despair nor become despondent, but with great confidence submit ourselves to your holy will, which is love and mercy itself. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you.
Have given them bread from heaven, alleluia. Oremus. Deus qui nobis sub sacramentum mirabili, passiones tuae memoriam reliquisti, trebuique sumus, ita nos corporis sanguinis tui sacra mystera venerare, ot redemptionis tui fructum in nobis iugita sentiamus, qui vives in regnes in saecula saeculorum. The divine praises. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be your holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be your glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, your most chaste spouse. Blessed be God, his angels and his saints. May the heart of Jesus, in the most blessed sacrament, be praised, adored, and loved with grateful affection at every moment with all the tabernacles of the world, even to the end of time. Amen.